Hey guys, welcome back. As I said in the previous video, part one, I will be taking apart the clutch master cylinder and the clutch slave cylinder, which is located down here in the front, to rule out any issues with it that may be causing the creaking and squeaking when I use the clutch pedal. I'll show the teardown first, then in the later half, I'll show you how to remove and reinstall both, along with the fluid drain and fill. Now I'm going to open this up. I will not be disturbing this nut, which is set from factory. There needs to be a little bit of free play before the pedal, before the rod touches the piston inside. You need a snap ring plier to open this circlip here, this retaining clip. So after 14 years, there is no rust inside. This is the main reason to change your fluid on time. There is some dirt or gunk inside. I'll clean this out with brake cleaner. The piston itself looks in great shape, no damage to the rubber seals. If there was a leak from this outer seal, you would have to replace it. I'll only clean this with a damp cloth and re-grease it. The easiest option, of course, would be to replace the whole clutch master cylinder, especially if the housing inside is rusted. To make things cheaper, you can just buy a rebuild kit. You can buy this piston by itself. The whole complete piece will come. It will come with some grease and it will come with this push rod. This stopper comes separate and this retainer clip or circlip. This also, this gasket. So it depends what you want. You can replace these separately if damaged. I'll have the part numbers for all of these listed in the description. The inner seal over here, you need to apply brake fluid. Then over here, on the outer seal, you will apply rubber grease. And over here also, apply rubber grease. I put a little bit more inside, that's where that rod will seat. Make sure the ring is pushed in. It does seem okay to me. Make sure you attach this hose back on in the same orientation. So it should look like this. Now that's ready to be installed back into the firewall. Remove this boot of the slave. I'll try to get this piston cup out. Okay, what I ended up doing was I just slightly tapped this area on some stairs and it came out. Now I don't see any rust, a little bit of dirt or whatever that is, maybe rubber material, but it is rust free. So like I did with the clutch master cylinder, I'll just clean this up and reassemble it. I cleaned the housing, the rod, spring with brake cleaner. I didn't apply any on the rubber part. Now if you have a leak, that means this rubber, single rubber seal over here has failed. You need to either replace the whole slave cylinder or you can just buy this part separately, this piston cup, which comes with the spring. Now this here, this over here, this is the rod which pushes into the clutch fork. Here's where the grease can dry up. You need to apply moly grease over here. Over time, this does wear out, and then there is more of a gap between this and the clutch fork. So you may hear a rattle when the car is idling. So if it's idling, there's more gap. This is hitting against the clutch fork. You can replace this rod. Again, part number will be listed in the description. Honda says to apply rubber grease over here. This is the only seal we have on the slave cylinder. The small end of the spring goes on this piston. On this rod, we need to apply rubber grease over here, basically where the boot rests. You need to apply rubber grease over here also, where the other end of the boot will rest. To remove the clutch master cylinder, I'll drain the fluid first. I'll remove this brake booster hose out of the way and then open the brake line. Then you have to remove the bottom two 12 millimeter nuts holding this in place from the clutch pedal inside. Remove a retainer clip and metal pin that connects this to the pedal. This was shown in the part one video, so I won't repeat it here. I'm going to drain whatever fluid I can from the bleeder valve. This is an 8 millimeter nut. Just crack this open. Now I'm going to connect a small hose to the bleeder valve, and I'm going to push the clutch pedal to get whatever fluid I can out. Now, because I'm just draining the fluid, air will enter the system, which means the clutch pedal will not return. That's fine. Manually pull it up. Put the other end of the hose in a drain pan. So now you can see fluid coming out. Coming out from here, the thread also, that's okay. I loosened it a little bit too much, but that's fine. I'll keep doing this until I can drain whatever I can. I'm going to crack open this brake line nut. That's a 10 millimeter nut. I'm going to use a flare nut wrench. This is a very useful tool that ensures you do not strip the nut. I have a container and some cloths underneath. You do not want brake fluid getting onto your paint. It will destroy it. You need to hold this in place, this 17 millimeter nut, while I crack open the brake line 10 millimeter nut. Okay, that's loose now. Fluid didn't fall because I already drained some before and there's no pressure in the line. That's what I wanted. Now I'm going to remove the nuts from inside and get the clutch master cylinder out. Pull this reservoir up. And pull the clutch master cylinder out. I'm going to leave the container here just in case any brake fluid decides to drip. Now over to the slave cylinder. You can get a squeak here where this rod interacts with the clutch fork. The grease over here does dry up over time. Just like the master cylinder, open the brake line first. It's the same procedure. Hold the 17 millimeter nut while opening the 10 millimeter brake line nut. Then open these two 12 millimeter bolts to remove the slave cylinder. Carefully push in the clutch master cylinder. I will loosely connect the brake line. Once I tighten the nuts inside, then I will finish tightening the brake line. When reinstalling it, or you just opened it to grease the end of this rod, I would suggest to put this bolt back in. It'll be easier to reassemble everything then. Apply moly grease on the tip. Grab the boot, push it in, and get the rod in the fork. Reinstall the second bolt. You have to push this in. Now I'm going to attach the brake line loosely before I tighten these bolts down. Clean off any excess grease. Before you tighten this down, push this in and push it out towards the fork. You want as little gap between that rod and the fork. Sometimes that does rattle, as I mentioned earlier. This is the torque wrench. And that's it. Just do the other one and you're all done. The only thing left to do is now to fill the system with fluid, brake fluid, bleed it, and test it. Now, there are two ways to go about this. You can do it by yourself. This hose, insert this into a bottle full of water. No point in wasting brake fluid. You push the pedal down. When you release it, it won't suck air back in. I prefer to do it with two people. I'll crack this loose. My little helper will push the clutch down. Then I will temporarily tighten it. And the clutch pedal will be pulled back up because there's currently air in the system. Now, while you're doing this, make sure that the fluid in the reservoir tank does not drop below minimum. Otherwise, you're just going to reintroduce air into the system. Okay, so I'm just repeating. Crack it loose. Push the clutch. Temporarily tighten. Release the clutch. As you heard, the squeak is still there, and I figured it out. It's coming from inside here. There is a clip or a spring or something that allows this to move back and forth. I need to put grease in there. But in order to get grease in there, I need to open this boot, and this kind of ripped when I tried earlier. So I'm going to order the part first before I open that. After opening the clutch master cylinder and finding it was in superb shape, I wasn't expecting the creak to go away, but the intensity has further reduced, so still making progress. The clutch pedal now is buttery smooth, minus the creak, of course. I will fix the squeak I identified earlier once I get the part. The creak, I have to figure something out. I want it 100% gone. It is that middle bushing I identified in the first video. As always, thanks for watching.